Hi, today we will take a look at bucket aggregation. The aggregation framework helps provide aggregated data based on a search query. It is based on simple building blocks called aggregations that can be composed in order to build complex summaries of the data. Especially the bucket aggregation. Bucket aggregation creates buckets of documents like group by in relational database. Bucket aggregations can hold sub-aggregations. We are going to take a look in the next pages. Here is the aggregation format. Don't be scared, the real aggregation will be easier to understand. Let's just skip this one for now. We need sample data to aggregate. Let me create a basketball index here. Curl minus x put and the Elasticsearch address and the index name is basketball and we created it now. We need mapping here for our documents. Here let's see the mapping information first. Vi basketball mapping.json file. As you can see here, the mapping is looking like this. We have to submit date as data format and a long format for points, rebounds, assists, and blocks. And we are going to add these mappings onto our index basketball. The command is like this. Curl minus x put, Elasticsearch address, index, and the type name as record using mapping minus d, add sign, and the JSON file here. And it worked. So let's take a look at our document here. Vi to teams basketball JSON. As you can see, here we have documents ID 1, 2, 3, 4. Two documents are about the Chicago team. And the other two documents for the LA teams. And we are going to add these documents into our Elasticsearch using curl-xpost. And it worked. So now everything is ready. We need to check our term aggregation first before we use it. So let's see vi terms aggregation.json file. As you can see, we have the size is 0 because we just want the aggregation result. And we can instead using the aggregations, we can use just AGGS here. And the aggregation name is players, and we are using the terms aggregation here using field team. So we are going to group by team and going to get the result using this aggregation. So let's run this command. As you can see, we have two Chicago team and two LA team, and I'm going to run this command curl-xget Elasticsearch address with the search option. Question mark pretty will give us the pretty result in JSON format. As you can see, we have the aggregated data here. Two documents are under Chicago and two documents are under the LA here. And aggregation stats group by team. So let's take a look another example here. You might think group by team doesn't have much information to analyst. So how about we can get the stats from each team? We can do it using metric aggregations from term aggregation. So let me show you here. Here's one another aggregation file I'm going to show you here. We have two aggregations here and here. So first we aggregate using the term. So we aggregate team. So group by team, then we are going to do another aggregation on this term aggregation we are going to get the stats using the points field from each teams. So let me run this one here. --x get Elasticsearch address and search option. I'm going to run this aggregation. And now as you can see, we have the two results, for one for the Chicago here. Chicago's document, the count, we have two documents, and the mean point was 20 points, max point was 30. And as you can see, the average and sum are correct. Also the LA, we can now know the LA Lakers team's stats here. The minimum point was 30, max point was 40, and the average point is 35 from the LA Lakers. As you can see, you can verify that every score or here, average, max, mean, sum, are exactly same value from this document that we put it in the Elasticsearch. That's it, and you always can get this source code from my GitHub website. Thank you very much, and see you on the next video.